Ohio Stadium in Columbus, Ohio, the Sooners of Oklahoma against the Buckeyes of Ohio State. This could be a game that'll have bearing on the eventual national champion. Oklahoma Sooners wearing white are coming onto the field. Oklahoma winning their first two games this year, ranked fourth, UPI, third, Associated Press. Oklahoma from the Big 8 Conference. Ohio State winning their first two, ranked third in the coaches' poll, fourth by Associated Press. And today, the Buckeyes and the Sooners in their first game.
More. So I don't think you're going to see Oklahoma's ball club intimidated. The game's going to be won on that carpet down there.
You say that because you're not down there.
And I think I'm happy of that.
All right, there are some other big football games being played today, too. Certainly this one is the ranking contest, but a big one between Texas A&M and Texas Tech. There's another big one in the southeast between Florida and Mississippi State, and a very big ball game being played at State College, Pennsylvania, between Maryland and the Penn State Nittany Lions. The deep men for Ohio State, Ray Griffin, 44, is in the middle. Jeff Logan is to his left or the right of your screen, and Mike Guess is Ron Springs is on this side of the field. So here's the kickoff now by Von Schumann as the wind carries it beyond the field of play. This way at quarterback with Rod Gerald, number 8. Ray Griffin will be the tailback, 44. Ron Springs, the fullback, number 23. And James Harrell, number 11, is the flanker. First down at the 20 for the Buckeyes. Harrell going in motion toward the line. The tailback, Ray Griffin, has the ball to the 21-yard line. Jimmy Moore at tight end, Chris Ward 272 at a tackle, Mark Lane played center 220 at guard this year, Doug Porter is at center today, Kenneth Fritz is the offensive guard on the other side, Joe Robinson number 70 at tackle, and Bill Jaco is the other tight end. And it's second down and 9 from the 21-yard line for Ohio State. Again, ball faked off this time to Griffin, given to Harrell, the wingback coming around, he is knocked out of bounds. The Oklahoma defensive front, Reggie Mathis, Dave Hutchins, Richard Murray at middle guard, Phil Tabor and Barry Purgett. The linebackers for Oklahoma, George Cumbie, a fullback last year, and Darrell Hunt. And the secondary for the Sooners, Darrell Ray, Terry Peters, Bud Hebert, and Zach Henderson. Now a change as Herman Jones went on the field and then came back off as they set up out of the eye. And this time it is Ron Springs working out of the tailback position. Ben McKee, a junior out of Columbus, will do the punting, fumbles the snap for a moment, hits it up in the air. The wind will get that knuckleball, and Oklahoma will get the football in very good field position. Will be Tom Lott at quarterback. Thomas making his first real healthy appearance of the year. Elvis Peacock, Billy Sims, and Kenny King will be the fullback. Well, Steve Rhodes, they split in. Oh, call it the 38-yard line, and first down, Oklahoma. Thomas Lott gives it to the fullback, the up man out of the wishbone, Kenny King. Trenches for Oklahoma, Carl Bildeschweiler, Jaime Melendez at guard. Paul Tabor is the center. The other guard is Greg Roberts. You see him pull a lot today. Sam Clappin is the tackle, and the tight end is Victor Hicks. It is second down and a long 7 for Oklahoma from the 41. Thomas Lott rides it down the line, turns it upfield, and he runs right into number 94, Dave Atkins. He did get yardage out of it. Ohio State lines up with Paul Ross, Byron Cato, Aaron Brown, Eddie Beeman, and Kelton Danzler. The linebackers, Tom Cosino, David Atkins, and the secondary, Tom Roach, Lenny Mills, Todd Bell, and Mike Guest. Todd Bell is a freshman at the 46-yard line, third down and 2.5 for Oklahoma. Lott goes the other way. Gets it. He's got the first down. Out of the wishbone, Rhodes is wide to the left side. And Lott gives it to the second man through. Billy Sims, second down, and 4 yards to go for the first down. Lott goes down the line with it. Delivers it outside. Beautiful play to Peacock. Peacock down the sideline, stepped out of bounds at the 33-yard line.
And Army plays Colorado next week, could be undefeated.
Lehman Holm, up. Oklahoma drops the ball. It's picked up by Peacock, and he's in the open. He dribbled it through the offensive and defensive line area and takes it into the end zone for a touchdown. Oklahoma put the ball on the ground. Elvis Peacock dribbled it through the trench area, picked it up, and it goes 33 yards for the touchdown. Now, he picked it up right about 10 yards beyond the snap area and took it on in. Picked it up and took it in. And Uwe von Schumann for the extra point. It is good. Dribbles it on down through the secondary, picked it up and scored, and Oklahoma leads 7-0, and the Sooners kick off deep to Ray Griffin, who they just say how many when it's all over, and Ohio State is down by 7, and they send it up the middle. The ball is loose! And Oklahoma gets the football! Inside the Ohio State 17, as Tom Lott options it down the line, turns the corner, and gets to the 14 for 2 yards. Second down and 8 with Rhodes wide to the left, unbalanced to the left. Lott gives it to the second man, Billy Sims, touchdown! From just inside the 15-yard line, Sims, behind the unbalanced line to the left side, had a big gaping hole, and he blew it in. And Oklahoma trying to blow it open right here in the early going.
Well, that's some kind of start. It's going to be tough for Iowa State to come back from this deficit.
As Uwe von Schumann lines up to hit it. Drills it. Well, how do you do? 11:05 to go. Ohio State offense has been able to do nothing. They really haven't had a chance. And the kick is deep into the end zone again, and Griffin lets it go. Then Cousinall becomes sort of the defensive general. Rod Gerald's all right. He's back in at quarterback. Wants to throw. Does. Misses. It is passed complete to Harrell, but he is out of bounds. He's wide to the right side. It is second down and 10. Gerald to throw it again. Going to run it up the middle. And third down, and Ohio State needs 2 yards for a first down. Gerald trying to get outside, won't do it. That's a great play coming. McKeon DePont rushes on, he gets it away. It's a decent kick. Fair catch is called by Freddie Nixon just outside the 40-yard line.
Got to be a little better after that.
First down, Oklahoma. It's Billy Sims carrying the ball, and he slashes through again. Third down and 3 yards to go from the 47. Second down, and I should say three. Lott delivers it outside to Sims. Sims has got his first down. He's there, just threatening to blow it open, as I said a while ago. They go in for another one. Look out. They give it to the fullback, Kenny King. Unbalanced to the left, wide to the right. Lott keeps it, delivers it back. Back, Billy Sims. Sims.
The late hit. Let's take a look. Here's a replay of it.
Paul Ross, 16, the defensive end coming across. He may have been the man letting himself go off the field of play to make the hit, and that's exactly right.
Yeah, so it's a long way off the sideline. That's right.
First down now, Oklahoma, as they profit from the penalty at the Ohio State 27-yard line. Sooners lead 14-0 first quarter, and it goes to the first man into the middle, Kenny King, and generally won't. And Oklahoma very often goes on a quick count. It goes to Kenny King, and King is to the 25, falls. They are wide to the right and overloaded to the left along the line of scrimmage as Thomas Lott turns it upfield. Tumble. Leading by 14, El Gamble. And linebacker for Ohio State is hurt. Fourth down and one. Second man, he's got the first down. Sims, 6 carries, 42 yards in the ball game and the touchdown. First down at the 13. Lott keeps it, turns it up. And Thomas Lott. That'll back him up 5 for illegal motion, and Lott. And second down 12 from the Ohio State 15, 5:10 to go. First quarter, Sooners lead 14-0. Thomas Lott with it, delivers it outside to Sims, and this time the Buckeyes defense it very well. As they come up to the line of scrimmage, the crowd comes with them. Lott.
Look
on
out,
a reverse to Rhodes, coming down the sidelines to the 10, and he's caught and dragged down at the 7-yard line for his fourth field goal of the season. Got a leg on him, and he's got it. A 28-yard field goal by Uwe von Schumann with 3 minutes and 29 seconds to play in the first quarter.
Really a surprise thus far.
Griffin will back up in the end zone and will not return it. Still 11 yards in this first quarter. And they send the up man, Springs.
Ohio State has started their own 20 now on every occasion.
Gerald gives the ball to Springs, the up back out of the I formation, 27. Gerald, outside it goes to Ray Griffin, and Griffin cannot get the first down yardage. He's been averaging at 35 plus in the first two games. Gets a little better handle on this one. Hangs it up very well. And it takes an Ohio State bounce. It is picked up by a Buckeye. Let's see if they whistle it back here. Whether or not an Oklahoma man had touched it. There's a penalty flag down on the field.
Here that he was blocked.
First down, Oklahoma at the Ohio State 45. Thomas Lott turns the corner with it and gets 5 yards. Specific time next Monday night here on ABC. The second man gets the ball. It is him. So rankle it all. Still fly. And Sims now has come out of the lineup, and David Overstreet, a freshman from Big Sandy, Texas, has gone in there. Thomas Lott, the quarterback, number six, keeps turning.
I haven't seen much of him. He is a real running back.
Second down and 7 yards to go. And Overstreet gets a taste of what it's like at Ohio Stadium, and the Buckeyes saw him coming, and they deck him for a loss. So the first quarter is over, and Oklahoma leads Ohio State 17 to nothing from the 28-yard line of Ohio State. Thomas Lott comes this way with it. Inside the 20 and close to a first down. This time, that puts three linemen on the left side of the center. Tom Lott comes to the weak side with it, turns it upfield. Second down, 8. Lott gives it. Nope, keeps it. On the down on the field, he, on the injury timeout, has gone off the field. Jay Jimerson, the freshman quarterback, who has played very well in the two ball games, saved the Vanderbilt game for Oklahoma. He's in at quarterback. Lott went off on his own power, though. Penalty flags down as Jimerson hands the ball inside to David Overstreet.
Fly. His statistics in the early going here, he's only played in two ball games. He's picked up.
Second down, the ball is backed up to the 18-yard line. A third down and 9, let's call it. And Jimerson keeps it himself. From the 23-yard line, it's a 33-yard field goal try by Von Schaumann. Plenty of leg. It goes into the crowd. It is good. He is 5 for 5 in 1977 in field goals. And with 12:50, Oklahoma only 19 for Ohio State. But this time, Ohio State may run it back. Ball is kicked in the air. It goes to Ron Springs at the 6-yard line. And Springs comes back to the 19. First down. Rod Gerald is the quarterback. Gerald drops to throw, and he throws over the middle, and it is incomplete, the pass intended for James Harrell. The Sooners dominating. Second down and 10. Gerald will throw again. At least he's going to try. Look out. Slides and falls down right about the 29-yard line. For the man closest to the quarterback out of the eye. Gerald wants to throw it again. Run it. And he, for the first time today, Joel Payton, the big freshman fullback from Mentor, Ohio, as he lines him up on a full house tee. And it goes to that big freshman fullback, Payton, brings the beat back. Gerald keeping. And he's inside the 35, full house tee. It's Payton, and Russell, and he's got a first down. 10:40 to go in the first half. Gerald, keeping, pitches, brings.
He's gone.
He's gone. It is touchdown, Ohio State. And Timmy Moore made the block that turned him loose on Zach Henderson. Janikiewski will try the extra point out of Jim Harrell's hole. Janikiewski hits it. Penalty flag down. The kick is good. Looked like Oklahoma might have been offside. 20-7 Oklahoma. Orris should get it out of the field of play as the wind is blowing 10 to 15, 20 miles an hour behind him to get on the board in the game. Oklahoma first down from the 20. Thomas Lott back in the ball game is hit behind the line of scrimmage. A little more than 10 yards now for Oklahoma from inside the 20.
Oh,
Ohio State got it. So the Buckeyes get a break as Oklahoma fumbles it for the 19th time this season. The Sooners turn it over. And Ohio State with a big opportunity. Rod cuts it upfield. He's got a touchdown from the 19-yard line, and suddenly we've got a ball game.
Wow!
You almost get the feeling, Ira, that something happened down on the field to wake up Ohio State. Jersey coming to the sidelines, 6 points. It's good. And so, here at Ohio Stadium, we have a ball game, the kind of a game we expected we would have between two great football teams. Wind at his back, Morris puts it off the field of play. Up, it is Freddie Nixon lining up at a halfback position. It is Jay Jimerson fumbling the ball. It is loose, and Ohio State has it at the Oklahoma 20. Paul Ross, number 16, came across the field to make the recovery. You expect, I suppose, the Sooners to have to gamble on defense. It's a 52 as they line up. Gerald sets to throw the ball. He's got some room. And he's backed up at the 14. Second down, four from the 14 of Oklahoma. Gerald and Springs bump together. He is a sophomore fullback at 212 pounds. And Ron Springs carries the ball. That's what we've got.
Look for a run action pass with Gerald faking.
Nope, they give it to that big fullback. The freshman fullback goes over the top, and he's close, and I don't know that he made it. Looks to me like the linesman may have marked him just a little bit short. Him in Michigan. So the Sooners hold and take over from just outside. They're on 10-yard line, and Billy Sims spins it up close to the 15. Into the wind.
Very good into the wind. Excellent punt.
Ohio State now with good field position at the Oklahoma 47-yard line. 5:53 to go in the first half of the game. Fumbled by Gerald. Ball loose. Sooners dive. And Ohio State had a man on the bottom who looked like he might have come up with it. Loss is back to the 49-yard line, where it is second down and a 12 to go as Harold goes in motion. And Gerald drops the throw. Getting some heat, gets it off, and it is incomplete. So it is third down and 12 from the Oklahoma 49. Sooners are leading 20-14 in the first half. And Gerald rolling around looking for somebody to throw to. No chance at that time, and that McKee's back. He should be able to get a hold of this one all right. It'll go to the end zone. So it'll be Oklahoma's ball, first down at the 20-yard line. First down, Oklahoma at the 20-yard line. 4 minutes and 22 seconds to go in the first half. The Sooners lead by 6 points, and Jay Jimerson is the quarterback. Comes up to the 22-yard line, and he is hammered. The 23-yard line, it is second down and 7 for the Sooners. Jimerson turns and gives, and the play comes straight ahead with Peacock. Game tried to hold the Sooners here on 3rd and 4. Jimerson turns it upfield, and he's got the first down. Good effort by the freshman quarterback.
Well, that's why college football is so unpredictable.
First down at the 31-yard line.
There's a turnover.
Fumble into the pile of people. Jimmy Rogers, and Ohio State comes up with a football. Sooners turn it over again. Look like Eddie Beeman. Here's Ohio State back in business at the Oklahoma 33-yard line. Rod Gerald, the quarterback. Turns, keeps.
He only had 10 men on the field.
Second effort up to the 30-yard line. Who only had 10
Ohio
men?
State. I believe there was no split receiver out there.
It feels better today. I want to play it tomorrow. Here he is playing. And Ron Springs. Outside to Ray Griffin. Ray Griffin inside the 22-T formation. Gerald coming the other way. Can't do it. Great play by number 26, Barry Burgett, the defensive end. He did not commit. He held his position, and he runs Gerald out for a loss, and the Sooners will take over the ball. Covered a fumble. Covered a fumble. So Jay Jimerson is in at quarterback, and second down and 8. And Jimerson gives it inside. And breaking it up over the middle is number 34. This game to be injured for Ohio State, if he in fact is. Here's Overstreet taking it wide and trying to get to the sidelines.
Fourth down on two occasions, they were able to stop the Ohio State Buckeyes.
Jay Jimerson is doing the quarterbacking, hands it to the up man, Jimmy Rogers, out of the wishbone, and the fullback at about half a yard as time expires. And the score at the end of the first half of play here at Ohio Stadium in the first meeting ever between Oklahoma and Ohio State, the Sooners 20 and the Buckeyes 14. A halftime statistics. And as you would expect, the edge goes to Oklahoma, Ara Farsegan. Freddie Nixon is the swiftest of the two. And they kick it. It goes to Nixon at the three. And they get him at the 22. Has obviously helped each team as they have switched ends of the field. Jimerson going down the line with the ball. And he fumbles. And a red shirt was after it. And Ohio State gets it. Denzler knocked the ball loose, and Lenny Mills, it looked like, got over there to cover it. And there's the first break of the second half. At the 23-yard line, first down, Ohio State. Oklahoma's 23. Rod Gerald delivers it outside, and it is Ron Springs who back the offensive front you saw. Gerald to throw it. Down he goes, and he's way back upfield, all the way at the 38-yard line. They would have to go to the Oklahoma 13 to get a first down. So the Sooner defense doing its job so far. Gerald goes down the line, steps back to throw. He throws it for Harrell. He threw it too long. He had James Harrell breaking downfield, and it is a 54-yard. One blocked at 52. The ball is down cleanly, and it's a bad kick. Thing that UCLA did. They had opportunities three times. Houston turned them away deep in Houston territory with nothing, and now Oklahoma is beginning to turn Ohio State away with nothing. That very sore. They are strong to the right side on second down and seven. Jimerson mixed up in the backfield. Quick kick. Peacock hits it into the wind. It is a bounce to the sidelines and out of bounds. All right, here's Ohio State at the 48-yard line of Oklahoma. First down. Gerald gives it to Ron Springs. Springs hit behind the line of scrimmage. The wide receiver split in. The other's in the flanker position, and Gerald rushes back to throw it. He has room on the sidelines. He has a man open over there, and that should get a flag. And it does. The penalty flag is thrown against Darrell Ray. And Ray bumps into him before the ball got there, and Ohio State has a first down. Second quarter, and the Bucks are threatening right here. Let's see if the Sooner defense is equal to this challenge as Gerald hands it off inside to Ron Springs. It is second down. The ball is sitting at the 13. Second down and seven. The right end, Jaco, I believe it is, moved on the play. And
that's way back. Yeah.
No, he's going to call it the other way.
Yeah, well, he was on his way back, and the reactions of the Oklahoma ball club.
Long for Ohio State. It is short at second down. Gerald gives it to Big Joel Payton. Up in the backfield, but it didn't bother anything as all the white shirts are up. Well, Zach Henderson drops off in the middle now. Full house backfield. Goes to the big guy. And Joel Payton is just short of the goal line. It's volley. And he is stopped short. Third down and goal from a foot away. It is Payton. Ahead for the first time today. It's good. With 8 minutes and 4 seconds to go in the third quarter, Ohio State gets the lead over Oklahoma 21-20. High kick, and Nixon will let it go. And Levitt gives to Overstreet, and Overstreet is decked. It's second down and 10, Oklahoma at the 20. Blevins fakes it and keeps it. Comes up the line and gets maybe 3 yards. They put King, the fullback, in motion. Blevins rolls to throw. Throws for Rhodes, intercepted. There's the turnover. It's intercepted by Kelton Densler, a defensive end who dropped off to actually play a linebacker position. In
the... But you never would have gotten the ball anyway. No. You've never gotten whether you're standing up or not.
Into the middle of the line goes Ron Spring. We'll see. Second down, 3. Gerald turns it. Gerald has a first down. First down at the 22 of Oklahoma. Rod Gerald keeps it, and goes down right about the line of scrimmage as Barry Burkett, number 26, came across the field, put him down, and looks like Gerald might be shaken on the play. And Greg Castagnola is in at quarterback for Ohio State. He's not the runner that Gerald is, and they will alternate and change their full house T formation. Castagnola to throw over the middle. Look what I found, catch by Tony Moore. The ball bounced off the hands of Blood Hebert right into Moore's hands, and Ohio State has scored. Monakiewski. It's good. And Ohio State's lead now. 4 minutes and 44 seconds to go in the third quarter is 8 points. Are the deep men. Orris sails it through the end zone.
Which is a factor.
Billy Sims is back in, sore ankle and all. They need him. He wants to go. Here comes Blevins down the line to Peacock. And Peacock is hit by Kelton Densler. Blevins gives to Sims.
That the midshipman put on quite a performance today, Keith.
Indeed. It is third and long. They send King in motion. They pitch it wide to Peacock. He's got King in front of him. He turns the corner. He's got a first down for the Sooners out of the 32-yard line. From the 31-yard line, Blevins stands to throw. Whips it to Rhodes. Steve's got it. And he's got another Oklahoma first down. Blevins still got it. Now pitches it and throws it out of bounds. And Blevins to throw. Lobs it up for grabs. Intercepted by Mike Guess, the cornerback. And the Sooners turn it over again. 5-yard line, Ohio State. Ron Springs taking the pitch out from Castagnola at quarter. Second down and 6. And Ron Springs, who will get a lot of work with Oklahoma's got 9 men up on that line. And the struggle for the first down by Joel Payton.
The event that Ohio State elects to do so.
Castagnola will put it up.
There it is.
Swings it out to Ray Griffin. And Griffin gets another first down. First down at their own 49. And Chris Ward, the left tackle for Ohio State. First down and 15 for Ohio State. Castagnola sets to throw it. Dives ahead close to the 45. We've come down to the final seconds of the third quarter in Ohio State with 15 minutes of this first game ever between Oklahoma and Ohio State. It is second down and about 5 yards to go for Ohio State at the Oklahoma 46. Castagnola pitches the ball to Ray Griffin, and Ray Griffin runs it to the 42-yard line. Third down and a short 2. It is Griffin. He's gone behind the line of scrimmage. Good defensive play by Oklahoma. McKee will hit it. Snap is on the money. Very little rush. McKee hangs it very well up into the wind. And it hits an Ohio State player and bounces back up the field. So, all right, Bill, first down. Oklahoma at their own 20-yard line. And Jermison gives to King. And King gets through that first wave of defenders. Goodness, he hits hard. 26-yard line. Second down, 4 Sooners. They trail by 8. Jermison, second man. And it is Overstreet, the 196-pound freshman out of the wishbone. Jemerson keeps. They hit him right at the 30.
Did it mark the ball? No, it's a goal.
Look at that.
A lot of time to go, but they're 8 points. They need two scores. They'd have, might as well line up and kick it down the field.
Wishbone is in tight. Quarterback keeps it. Jimerson dives. He's got it. Jimerson to King. And King is game tackled right along the line of scrimmage. All righty, second down. Call it 9.5. Here's the pitch to Peacock to get him out 1-on-1. He won a fumble. And I think an Oklahoma man recovered it. 36-yard line, third down and 5. Peacock wants to option the ball. Now he's got to run for his life. Loss is back to around the 31-yard line. With the wind at their back, and it's Uwe von Schroman to do the punting for the Sooners. He gets it up all right. Mike Guess is going to watch it bounce for a while, and it takes an Ohio State bounce as it comes straight to the sidelines. First down. At the 32 for Ohio State, Castagnola keeps it and runs for 9 yards. The full house tee. Figures a big freshman fullback, number 30, Peyton, gets the ball. Huh? Yep. 42-yard line. First down, Ohio State. They lead by 8 points, and Ray Griffin has the ball. And Griffin running out of the tailback position. The rain has stopped. Temperature comfortable. Field in good shape. Castagnola keeps. Now delivers it outside to Ray Griffin. Griffin breaks the tackle. And he is cut down. And it is third down and inches for the first down. Full house backfield, and it is Peyton, the big freshman fullback, just inside the 45, first down Buckeyes. Kinlaw, the middle guard, leading the defensive charge for 28-20. Ohio State leading. Castagnola wants to throw it. Better hurry. Caught behind the line of scrimmage. With 6.5 minutes to play in the game, it is third down and 12 for the Buckeyes. Castagnola is caught. Fumble! Oklahoma gets it. Kinlaw. Dave Hudgens, number 70, came in there and squeezed the ball loose.
62 there. I couldn't
tell. Reggie Kinlaw.
Is that Kinlaw there?
All right, Dean Blevins, the quarterback, delivers it outside. It is David Overstreet, the freshman running back. Victor Hicks wide to the right. Rhodes to the left. Gives it up the middle, Kenny King, and he's inside the 30-yard line. First down from the Ohio State 29. The pitch is outside to Elvis Peacock. Peacock trying to find some daylight. Good defensive flow by Ohio State. Second down and 11. The pass to Rhodes. Caught. Good catch. The ball was drilled in there by Blevins at the 20. Second man, Overstreet. Roared, helmet came out of there. They thought it was the ball. Oh, sure, they'll go for two if they get one across here. It is first down from the 18. Blevins to Overstreet. And he ran right out of the arm. Second and 5 from the Ohio State 13, King in motion. They pitch it to Overstreet, runs away from a tackler. And Ross runs him down. Big shoes to fill, Bob Grudzinski. Third down, 5. Peacock. They drill him. Fourth down, and it is a short 4 or a long 3. Let's call it 3. Fourth and 3 for Oklahoma at the Ohio State 12.
I think Ohio State.
They got him, but there's a penalty flag thrown by the line judge, and I'm not so sure but what one of the red shirts didn't move on the left side of the defensive line.
That's what it looked like, Keith. It looked like the left guard. Yeah, they signaled it. There it is. Boy, that's a big penalty.
First and goal to go. Just outside the 7. Second man, Peacock. Again, the crowd roars. Overstreet out about the 3. 2:12 to play in the game. Blevins keeps to the 1. Fourth and goal inside the 2.
On the part of Oklahoma just before the ball was snapped.
No flag.
No flag down?
Nope. The Sooners now with a chance for the two-point conversion and tie it up. 28-26. And here's the two-point try to tie the game. Levins. Peacock. No. Mike Guest and Paul Ross. Paul Ross and Mike Guest. Here comes an onside kick. You can almost bet your mortgage on it. Oh. Oklahoma may have it.
Got it.
Let's see which one of the Sooners got it. Ohio State man reached out for it, and the ball caromed off his arm. Was the man that let the ball get away from him. From midfield, pass complete. It is caught by Steve Rhodes. We have a minute to play in the ball game. First down, Oklahoma, Ohio State, 33-yard line. They are now within field goal range. It's Kenny King over the right side, and he takes it to the 26-yard line. 30 seconds to go in the game. Second down and three at the 26 for Oklahoma. They give the ball to the second man, Overstreet, and he's dropped short of the 25 at the Ohio State 26-yard line. The Sooners have one timeout remaining, 18 seconds to play in the game. They send Kenny King up the middle with the ball. 41-yard field goal to win it. It is long enough. It is good.
Wow.
With 3 seconds to play in the game, the Oklahoma team and some of their fans have come onto the field as Von Schaman hit it on the money. Just a few yards away from this exultation, Ohio State players still lie prostrate on the field, pounding the turf in frustration, walking dismally away. Oklahoma jumped to a 20-0 lead. Ohio State stormed back to score 28 unanswered points and lead 28-20. Their first turnover, a fumble, and Oklahoma took the ball in for the touchdown to pull within two as they failed on the two-point conversion. And then Oklahoma, exercising opportunity once more from midfield, took it down to field goal range, and a 41-yarder by Uwe Von Schaman is good for delay of the game for the Sooners, but they don't care.
They want
the
clock to start.
It up in the air.
They want the clock to start.
And it does. Oh, and it stops with 2 seconds to play. Kurt Gowdy Jr. And here's the final play of the ball game. Castagnola back to throw, getting some pressure. Oklahoma dropping back. He's still running around and still knocked down. And finally, he is loose, runs it up the sidelines, keeps on coming. And finally, the final tackle of the ball game is made by Dave Hudgens. And that is a fitting payoff to the whole story, because it was Hudgens who was very much a part of the moment that offered the opportunity for Oklahoma to ultimately win the ball game by a score of 29-28. The Prudential College scoreboard will be coming up shortly. But this first meeting ever between Oklahoma and Ohio State, just as exciting as everybody had anticipated it might be. Ladies and gentlemen, I don't believe you can watch a more exciting or better football game anywhere.